An Edmonton nail salon turned into the looks and sounds of an underground nightclub.
You guys don't know where this is. You're never...
No one at the social gathering in these videos appears to be wearing any masks nor social distancing.
Why?
All in violation of Alberta's Public Health Act.
Birthday girl!
This video was sent to us on February 28th, the weekend before police busted Chrome Beauty Lounge on the city's south side for hosting what police say were up to 125 people.
We on the news. I don't really care, all right? I knew that there's one way this was going to end, which was by the police busting down that door.
The next day, this Instagram page popped up with more videos from inside the salon, including what appears to be the business owner partying it up with the guests, and then posting this video to social media after the police bust.
But you know what? I got all my homies out of there safely. A few of my homies got busted. But guess what? This is not really going to be anything crazy. It's just a ticket, which when you go to court, those are getting dropped. So don't worry. I'm going to be fine. I'm going to get a fine. It's all good. I'll take it to court.
There seems to be a shift from perhaps individuals who maybe violated the rules but didn't say anything to individuals who are violating the rules and are being very public about it.
This law and health expert at the University of Calgary says fines have been inconsistently levied and videos like this could encourage more people to break the rules.
And I think it's frustrating too for members of the public who have been following the rules fastidiously for the last year to see others not only breaking the rules but breaking the rules in a way that kind of makes a mockery of the rules themselves.
Chrome Nail Bar has three locations in the city. A south side location where these videos were apparently taken and a shop downtown and in Leduc. We spoke to the owner of all three locations. She admits she knew about the parties but called police and their landlord in an attempt to stop the parties.
This is extremely upsetting. Like we're embarrassed. First of all, because we ended up getting into business with people that we trusted to represent our brand in the most professional way possible, and that's not how it went about things.
Co-owner of the Southside Salon, Farida Hussein, has told media that she and her partner, who appears on video, rented out the salon to 15 people celebrating a birthday. She even apologized for making a selfish decision that she says was meant to support the struggling business. Our calls for comment on these recently surfaced videos were not returned in time for broadcast. EPS says they are working with Alberta Health Services to decide the next steps in the investigation. In Edmonton, Rochelle Soufi, City News.